Morning.
Morning. How's your plan off today?
No, I had to cancel. I've got some more important stuff to do. Matter of fact, how about make sure Chris Elrod gets this?
Okay.
Chris, I have a very important mission for you.
What?
I've assembled a list of all the new policies that we need to implement here at ScanSource in order to increase our efficiency by 15%. Your mission, should you choose to accept it, is to execute the policies I've laid out for you in this list. Here's the catch. I need you to get them in place by the close of business today. I've sent you an email to your phone. This email contains
the only copy
of the list. So don't lose it. Now let me introduce you to your team. Todd Iceman Graham. Specialty, staying cool under pressure. Just remember, don't get too close. He likes to dress in spandex and ride bicycles, and that's just weird. Steve, the Preacher Newton. Specialty, putting the fear of God into his enemies. Terry, all business Richardson. Specialty, business plans. This woman doesn't leave her cubicle without a business plan for how she's going to make it back. Next up is Bob, the Builder Thompson, AKA the Pack Rat. Yes, if you're looking for a computer part that was made in the latter half of the 19th century, you'll find it in his group. Rick, Mr. Fix-It-Berg. You got a problem, he can solve it. Specialty, solving problems. So that's your team, Chris. You have until the close of business today to show me some results. Keep in mind that no one is to know of your mission. If you or any of your team should be caught or asked what the heck you're doing, I will disavow all knowledge of you, your team, and your mission. Good luck. This message will self-destruct in 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey, Chris, you feeling okay?
Yeah, sure. Why?
I don't know. I just needed to talk to you. Listen, you still have one of those company-issued Trio phones, don't you?
Yeah.
Because only certain people are going to be allowed to have those phones, so I'm going to have to get yours.
What am I going to do for a phone?
Well, you got a phone.
Yeah, but that's a landline. What am I going to do for a cell phone?
Well, I'll see if I can get you a long cord. How's that?
You're killing me.
Just give me your phone. Thanks. And by the way, I'm going to check with accounting and see if that's the company issued Etch-A-Sketch, too.
Great.
All right, guys. Mike's given us a very important mission. He's given me the only list of new corporate policies that will save our company money and increase our efficiency by 15%. We have to complete these items by the end of the day today.
Well, I just don't think this is going to work.
Well, we might have to cut a few corners.
Wait a minute. I thought Bob was on this team.
Bob quit again. Considering the complexity of our mission, I've decided to bring in a veteran. I'd like to introduce General Blood and Gut Big Daddy Baker.
Be seated. Now, I want you to remember that no sales rep ever won a deal by cutting margins for his customer. He won it by making the other poor distribution sales rep die for his company. And all this stuff you've heard about ScanSource not wanting to compete, wanting to stay out of the deal, is a lot of horse dung.
All right, chew ads. Thank you, General. Thank you, General.
What?
Sorry about that, guys.
So when can we see this list?
Well, that's the problem. Mike sent the only copy to my cell phone, and Scott requisitioned my cell phone this morning.
Well, isn't that just great? Now what are we gonna do?
Well, I thought you were supposed to be some sort of big problem solver.
Here, now I've come up with a plan.
Could you not make it a little simpler?
What do you mean? This is the simple version.
Scott keeps all the cell phones that he's requisitioned locked in a file drawer in his office. The only problem is he keeps the key on him at all times.
I don't know, Chris. This sounds a little risky.
But this is what we're gonna do.
Terry's gonna create a diversion by dropping her notebook. When Scott bends over to pick it up, Todd's gonna come by and steal the keys. He'll pass his keys off to me, because we're gonna need those keys to get into Scott's desk. Terry and I will make our way to the Georgetown room adjacent to Scott's office. From there, I can enter the ceiling and gain access to his office undetected. Steve will provide a distraction by wasting company resources, which we all know Scott hates.
Hey Scott, what's up?
What the hell?
Rick will track Scott's movements through the security cameras.
Copy that, Rick. Here, call my cell.
Uh-oh. What do you mean, uh-oh?
I forgot to mention that I ran into Scott this morning. Hey, Scott. I've been meaning to ask you. I've been wanting one of those new phones.
Well, come on, man. We're trying to cut back on them, but I just got this one from Elrod, but we go back a long way, so take it, but don't tell anyone.
I won't. I appreciate it, though. Hey, thank you, Scott.
All right.
But when I get down from here, I'm going to show you who's Big Daddy.
Chris, you've got about 5 seconds. Get out now.
Quit! Big Daddy, pull me up.
Chris, Todd just bought you about 15 seconds.
Scott, let me help you up. I'm sorry about that. I didn't see you standing there.
Todd?
The hell?
I need to see you in my office.
Okay.
Hey, Todd, don't you have one of those company PDA phones?
Yeah, I do, actually.
I'm afraid I'm going to have to take it from you. By the way, is that a company shirt?
Yes, sir, it is.
I'm going to need it.
Is it Friday?
I make this look good.
I see, Todd, you made it out of Scott's office with nothing but your dignity.
No, I think he took that too.
All right, guys, enough already. I only got a few hours before I have to report back to Mike. Buck, hand me my phone.
The first task is to find an alternative fuel source for the coach. The second task will be to streamline the employee review process.
Oh, hey, Stacy. You ready for your review? Come on in, have a seat. Okay, well, let's see how you rate.
Whoa, Buck.
What happens if you don't even hit the target?
What? Oh, well, that just means you're fired.
Terry, why don't you take the third task? Find a more reliable power source for the building.
I'm sorry.
Do you need water? Do I need to get Darnelli?
No, I'm good, thanks.
Steve, why don't you see what you can do about accelerating accounting's year-end processes?
Steve, man, we certainly do appreciate all the additional staffing. We've been short here in accounting, and these guys seem to be a little quick on the shredder.
Shredded paper.
And Steve, where'd you get these guys at again?
Well, they were pretty cheap.
Okay.
Okay, and the last one, and probably the most difficult one, is finding a less expensive venue for the President's Club.
So, Mitch, you ready for President's Club?
Yeah, man, I'm really excited.
Good. Have you ever been before?
No, this is my first year.
Yeah. All right, guys, let's go.
All right, let's get this over with.
Okay, guys, what did we find? Did any of these ideas work?
I don't know about the rest of you guys, but I feel fairly confident that none of these policies are any good.
I've got to agree with Rick. I've got a 4-year-old, and I think he could come up with better policies than we've got here to work with.
Are we sure we interpreted these correctly? They sounded good to me. I think we cut too many corners.
Cut too many corners? There's no such thing as cutting too many corners. My middle name is Cutting Corners. Besides, I'm getting a little bit stressed here. I got to meet with Mike any minute now and tell him that none of his ideas worked.
Chris, all right.
Chris, hey, it's Mike. Listen, I really need to get those results from you as soon as you can.
Yeah, I'll be right over.
You need to see me?
Hey, Chris, come on in. Have a seat. So what do you have for me?
Well, Mike, honestly, I don't think that the list was as good as you thought it was.
What are you talking about, Chris? I'm looking at the timesheets for all the IT personnel. Minus those on your team, of course, and their efficiency has gone up tenfold since I signed you the mission this morning. If the new policies didn't work, then how do you account for this increase? Man, what a day these IT guys have been having. They have been more productive today than they've been the whole first half of the year combined. I don't know what you did, but good work, man.
Well, Mike, this mission kind of reminds me of when I was working on the Frito-Lay project.
Hey, don't tell me any more about these stories. I don't want to hear another one of these Frito-Lay stories. What are you trying to do, negate the entire increase and efficiency you gained today in one single story? Besides, I probably already heard this story anyway.
So you called me in here to...
Listen, Chris, I just wanted to tell you in person how good a job you and your team did.
Well, okay. I don't understand how it worked, but this isn't the first time I've taken credit for something I had nothing to do with.
Hey, Amy. Got any messages for me? So, hey, how'd it go today? Perfectly. Just as we expected.
Mike, they had no idea. With the manager's gone, we got so much more work done.